I'm just gonna hit straight in, cause oh wait, what's going on? Okay. Composition's done and map. You know, this is the part that always stumps me because I have some mental image, but not exactly enough to fill this with stuff. Oh, whoops. Kind of never understood what the foreground background brush is for. I want this to be kind of a cold and not so welcoming home. So let's put where's the snow back snow flooring? Thank you. What? Where's my snow? Well, you know what? They can have a river in the back. It's fine. I kind of wish there was a more efficient way to build this. Maybe put this somewhere here. Like, tiles are great, but oh fuck. Why can't I? Those are great, but I don't wanna have to keep copy pasting, you know? Is it a one-story house or a two-story house? Or do I make it a fake? No, I want it to be a two-story house for reasons. Okay, in that case, I probably don't have space for whatever this was. And then brush. Okay, then this lower area will be the lower ground, and then this will be the upper ground. Wait, missed call. I have a missed call from US. Actually, I didn't even need this, right? Because I could just I've got to check how loud is the. Wait, there's no. Oh no, there's no. Spotify. Window source. It's my Spotify. Okay, that's actually softer than I wanted, but we can do this. Boom, 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 boom. Boom, boom, boom. Wait, why doesn't it align? Align nicely. How does the modular stairs work? Every time I go to work, go to office, I come back with a cough. It's so unfair. Yeah, let's get bits for the 7th quarters with mildly questionable living conditions. All servants is probably enough for the household. And which also means that this area would probably be the kitchen, then you have the dining hall here, and I don't know what else. Oh, and mini stairs. So, stairs here and here. Oop, what am I hearing? I got a ping, but who pinged me? Probably not important. I think I do want a banquet table, but I need it to have a tablecloth. Maybe we get this. That's a decent length. Then we have tablecloth. Actually, maybe if I search table, it might have tablecloth that I want. Oh, that's Gothic dining table. Yes. But that's not long enough. Light? What's light? Sorry. Let's go with this. Let's move this here, then put in a fireplace. Okay, sorry, I'm gonna be coughing a lot. Oh my gosh.
See your butt.
Hi, Shiny! Wait, does this mean your stream's over? Oh, your stream is over. You've raided Wobbop. Okay. I am also lurking in Wobbop's stream. But yes, hello, Shiny. I am making maps. Which is really just me using the step tool over and over again. I don't really get much choice in chairs. Okay, fine. I was hoping that was gonna scare you. Do you make all your maps? No. So for most of, well, Beyond the Witchlight, the map actually comes from the map actually comes from the module. But for in this case, well, for my one shots and also for this background story for Endercoast, I don't have maps to go off on. There is actually one map that I saw on Incarnate that I kind of liked, but it doesn't serve the purpose extremely well. So, whoops, whoops. No, please, go back. Go back. Where's the one that I like? Yeah. So this is the one that I saw. It's got the layout more or less similar to what I wanted, but then it's got this weird piano room and this very small study and extra rooms that I don't need. So, like if I use this, then I would need to modify the story somewhat to fit this in. And the person that has made it so that someone else can't clone and edit their map, so I need to recreate it. But yeah, usually I don't make the map unless it's fully homebrewed. It's a fully unless it's a game that I fully what's that? Make from scratch, I guess. This map is so weird. This not this step. This step. It's like what is the angle of this chair? It's not fully top down. And I do not have enough space for all these. Oh no, my furnace is in there. My fireplace. This room might be too large. And also, how would I access this room in this corner? Okay, I'm gonna need stone walls, so that the kitchen doesn't set the house on fire. You know what? I think this area, this room in the corner can be perfectly inaccessible from the outside. So you'd have to go through the dining room, and then get here, or you have to go to whatever room is here and then get there. Because I'll use that as the dad's workroom, study room, office, and then we don't want guests just freely walking into his office. And then we can have this as the guest room. So if someone comes in, they want to see him, then they have to wait in the waiting room, and then he'll come see them through his office. Then we can have stairs here and here. And then what do I put here? I need to use the toilet. I'll be right back. I am back. Headphones are flipped. I was thinking, maybe I could make this into a living room, lounge area sort of thing, like this. But then the space is kind of small. You have to head off to sleep. Okay, have a good rest, Shiny. And then eventually we will stream this map somehow, which might still clash with your sleep schedule. So if this is the thing, the kitchen door should probably be somewhere in the middle. Probably. Thank you. Okay, so this needs to be further out so we can just hide the ugly stone walls, right? I can put something like this here. It perfectly. I still have no idea what's gonna be in this room. I could put a study, but okay. I guess some estimate of a staircase would help also. So let's stairs. And is there like a gothic, oh, you know what, redwood stairs, redwood railings. I need to flip this so that I can get it like that. Okay, let's give them walls for this bit. Right, this is probably too far. Oops. Okay. These two come here. This comes here, and then these two come here. Oops. Hello, Wolfie. Hello, Hermit. Look, it's a. Hang on, I'm not done. It's a snowy noble's house that we're building. Need to bring this on top. Move up a layer. Oh my gosh, what just happened? Doesn't fit. The walls don't fit the house. Is there like a. What's this? Ooh, okay. Anyway, I need like a very, very small. There we go. Looks like it doesn't align. Does it just not fit? Oh, okay. I guess that's it. How are you, Wolfie and Hermit? How is Saturdays? This bit's so weird. Can I move you down? And I can put one of these over here. And then because the nobles never go into the kitchen, no one needs to know about the weird architectural monstrosity that's behind the fancy wooden walls, which is really just this unaligned doorway. You didn't sleep very well, and you're a bit annoyed at trivial nonsense. Do you wanna talk about the trivial nonsense, or? But also, hey, if you didn't sleep very well, at least you have infinite mugs of coffee making. I think everyone should have like a magic item that's like for their personality, you know, like Woofy has mugs of infinite coffee. So you don't need to make like three or four pots of coffee. You can just keep sipping from that same one same mug, and it'll never get cold because the coffee is always fresh. You're gonna use your secret weapon later. You have some Kopi O Kosong from Old Town. Nice. But why Kosong when you can have it with sugar? Totally not me with an unhealthy addiction to sugar. Okay, I need still thing. And probably this can't be this. We need the cross-section one. Oops. Yes, you can add sugar or milk later. But then, oh, okay. So it's for the maximum customizability. Like if there's some days you don't feel like adding milk and sugar, then you can. Oops, no. Oh no. If there's some days that you don't feel like adding milk and sugar, then you can just not, and then right, yes, nice. It doesn't align. It doesn't align. As for the trivial nonsense, not really worth talking about. Okay, that's good. Well, you can calm down and relax from the trivial nonsense with lo-fi hip-hop beats to work or study to. And maps. Wait, why does it? Oops. This is too large. Oh, it's still too big for this. Oh no, it kind of fits. Haha, haha. The little Discord noises in the background are from wait. Oh yeah. It's because I'm also commissioning an artist for two portraits for this game. I need to put in railings. That got some underneath. Oh, I should probably look for the railings for the stone. And wait, yes, there we go. Where is it beneath? Slightly larger, just so you connect with the wall. Yeah, there we go. And then, I want you to be covered up by the wall. Why is it not moving? Oh, because I was on the wrong keyboard. think I saw this. Yeah, I could put in another one of these, and then that kind of saves me a hassle, I think. No, it gives me a new one. Oh, this little line in the design gets me every time. It's like, is it not aligning? Oh, it is not aligning. Hello, Brenna the Greenway. Welcome to the stream. How are you and how did you find my channel? Yeah, sorry. My brain just froze for a minute there. Okay, this is too large. The coffin is too large for the hole. Oh my god, what if? What if that play that everyone does for Singapore Youth Festival is a euphemism? What if the coffin is a euphemism for something else? The grandfather's coffin was too large for the hole. Maybe we should cut the coffin in half. Maybe we should widen the hole. Murph? Wait, what do you mean, Murph? Actually, the dad should have a fireplace too, right? Mean, so should this room. This is a problem. Architectural problem! See, we do have this weird little elbow thing, so we could elbow into the wall. And then put like a little this thing. And then both this and the elbow can just go below. I think the elbow needs to go below as well. Nice, and then there's like a very nice space for fireplace. Which really doesn't need to be this big. Getting hungry. Wonder if we can just select these. Nice. Okay, we can. We don't need you anymore. Oops. Oh no. What have I done? Thanks for the thanks for the follow. Smoking AB or smoking AB? Or is it smoking Gab? And also, what do I call you? Do I call you smoking or Gab or AB? Welcome to the I should write this down. I keep saying that I would write it down on post-it notes and I still haven't written it down. Welcome to the Cardboard Guild. If you don't have a weapon yet, help yourself to some cardboard in the corner. And how did you find my stream? Does the snoot in coffee thing. Enjoy your coffee. Will there be milk and sugar? Or perhaps you want me. Meanwhile. But yes, I am making maps for a D&D game. I usually run Dungeons and Dragons game. It's supposed to be every week. And the new schedule is that it's going to be every Saturdays from 10:30 to 1:30 Singapore time. That's UTC plus 8. But the next session that involves everyone is going to be a boss fight, and we want everyone for it. So it's postponed because not everyone can make it today. That's a dangerous proposition. Well, Woofy, under you is also a proposition. Wait. Right. Right? I'm getting my English grammar correct, right? Because, like, under is a proposition. No, under is a proposition, under you is a position. Wiggles eyebrows back. Okay, I need a door. I need a door, and you're adorable. Wouldn't you love to wake up to coffee, sugar, milk, and Opsidai by your bedside? I mean, what? Oops. What did I just do? Okay. Well, I only need one of you. And I need a door. Wait, I was doing an intro and then I got distracted. Yes, I stream D&D. I also stream other games. And I also make art, so later today I will be streaming again and I will be making art. Wait, does this mean that my It does, right? This room needs to have a wall as well. A wooden wall. So this is wrong. We need one of these. Wriggles eyebrows? Well, I wriggle eyebrows back at you. Not long enough. Doesn't fit. Actually, could I, oops, could I just put this right, and I have it fit as close to the edges of both sides as possible, and then I put this on top of it. I probably can't. Yeah, it looks ugly. Oops, I selected the wrong one. It's this one. Honestly, this is the most progress I've ever made on building this house. There was like a few weeks ago that I wanted to build this house, and then I was like, but it's so big. It's so much work. I don't have the motivation to do this. And then I went on to play Hogwarts Legacy. Look at that. Beautiful rooms, and then one very cold room. You know what? This could be the library, right? Like I just line this room with shelves upon shelves, and then it's where all the studying happens. Oh no, but then why would you make the library within close access to strangers? I still need to figure out what's this room for. The storeroom, maybe. So this is a rating room. It's gotta have a nice couch. The weird placement of the fireplace makes this difficult. Chair. Actually, could I just see what's in the Gothic horror section and then only pick from it? Right? That makes sense. Oh, that's a very big round table. Is there no in between? I hope you don't have any bear friends that might be worried about their companions being used as a it's a very big bear. Maybe it should be this way. No, not potions. I need some place to put my plants. Know what? Fine, I'll put this. I think this is too much redwood. Let's give it a normal floor. It's a bit too dark. Yeah, at least then you can see the bear rug. Advanced settings. Can I have a smaller flooring? What's happening? Ooh. Ooh. Yes. Thank you. That's for that. Actually, the front of the house and this part looks nice, but I want his study to be to have kind of a dark vibe to it. So let's get a different flooring. Maybe the dark wood floor actually, but too large. What's the skill that I use for this? Oh, it doesn't have? No. 58.03. Which side of the desk is the side that the person uses? I think it's the this way. Actually, you know what? Since there's a door on the right side, this is probably the best arrangement. I don't know, this is hard. Like this would protect him from intruders coming in this way, and then this and then he needs to make a quick escape this way. That's acceptable, I guess. Still can't get the placement right. No. This, I think this should, after all, be somewhere here. Consider saving my work. Thanks for reminding me. What's a rich person without a wine cabinet? Aha. And I guess a rug, but actually think I might not be able to finish enough of this in time. Oh, and I still need to divide up the room above, the floor above. Okay, you know what? I should have done this earlier, which is I should have taken the frame of the house beneath. It's very messy, but at least I can get the parts of it to fit. So there'll be one room that's above the kitchen, and I'll need to put in walls for that. And then this is this leads down. Probably there'll be another room this way, so let's take this. Oh, crap. Fine. Staircases, staircases. Crap. Thank you. Oh, the shadow's messing with it. Well, I guess that's all we can do for that. It's the album. A rich person without a wine cabinet, probably one that doesn't like wine and doesn't also want to be pretentious. Fair. But also I think the father is stressed enough to actually have a wine cabinet. Hello, Geo. Yeah, I'm streaming on D&D, but I'm essentially making a map which is going to be for Endercoast's backstory session. Which is in its part two part, because I guess expectedly or unexpectedly, during part one of the Endercoast backstory session, Endercoast wished to have his mother returned. And so Zebilna cast the wish spell and altered the timeline. We changed how things went in the past, and Endercoast finds himself in his home, and past the door he can hear his parents arguing down the hallway. And so yeah, I am building the house that they will that the next backstory session will happen in. The thing I like about the backstory about this, like it's not expected, because by wishing that his mother is back, he doesn't have the motivation to go on adventures and everything that's happening in the main campaign wouldn't happen. So this is like timeline shenanigans right here, but. At the same time, what I love about it is also this gives me the chance to put in a lot of juicy lore into the game. But anyway, Jiro, how's your morning going? I need a door and then your landing. Oh, you know what? Since I have a landing, I need to have a railing here as well. Oh, and a chandelier. Do I put elbow stairs to connect to here? Yeah, I think I should. I hear concerning noises above me. Okay, but I don't see monkeys, so it's fine. Probably. Actually, I think this complicates stuff. I'll just put in railings so that we have like. The landing is over here. But I do want to put in like an arch kind of thing. Let's see. I could put this. This is honestly more aesthetic than functional, but what do I put here? I know I'll put here. Let's see. Not every room needs a fireplace, right? No, but we do need some form of heating. I think this would be like the master bedroom. This would be Endocorsa's room, and then here can be a study, and wait. What kind of rooms would the rich person have in their house? Not a modern rich person, but olden days rich person. Noble mansion layout. Ballroom. Oh, okay. So the I think ballroom would be if they're very rich, but this is not rich enough to have a ballroom. Gallery, conservatory, indoor garden. Okay. Maybe. But this is on the upper floor also. Like ballroom and gallery probably not for this case. Because so their level as a nobility is they're on the lower ranks. They're on the lower ranks, and their status as nobility is highly dependent on them maintaining their income source and the lands that they own. Think this was the one that I was using as reference a few weeks back, but like to see what would be inside. Where's the map? That's not the right image. Oh, right. Oh, that's the image. Okay. Entrance hall, mayor's privy, special guests privy. Special guest. Oh, right. I guess they could have a guest room, guest bedroom. Balcony, guest rooms, empty room, forbidden rooms. Forbidden room. Seventh room, seven quarters. Oh, yeah. Banquet hall, I mean, there's a dining room already. East sitting room, kitchen storage. Oh, right, no. Okay, so this room here could be the kitchen storage. I'll need to redo the stonework, but that's possible. I still don't know what all these are. Let me just delete these. Oh, actually, I didn't need to. Oh no, I needed to do that. That's fine. That's fine. Okay, at least this would give me a sense of what to expect for here. If I more of like when I remember to do this. Wait, hang on. What's going on? Maybe a fancy room attached to the kitchen for refrigeration using massive blocks of ice imported straight from Icewind Dale. Nice. That sounds awesome. But this is a highly magical family. They could probably also have the room enchanted for cooling purposes, cooling and freezing purposes, right? Oh, but yes, they would definitely have massive blocks of ice inside there. Imported from Icewind Dale, of course, together with knucklehead trout. But wealth flaunting. Unless they aren't that sort of family. They're not wealth flaunting family, because compared to no to other nobles, they don't have as much wealth. But they are the kind of like they're the kind of people that get their status from that sort of climb to their status. Well, one of them climbed to status. The other one already has money and status to begin with. So it's a financially beneficial partnership, is how they ended up in their relationship. But I think I still have a problem, which is I'm not fully sure what to populate the upper floor with. Let's just populate the procrastinate the upper floor by making this ice storage room a very important room. You know what? Lazy. I'll just put this on top of it. Actually, I think it, yeah, they aren't the sort of family like it would be more accurate to say that behind closed doors, they aren't the sort of family to flaunt the wealth, except maybe one of them. It's a small family of three. It's hard to pinpoint. It's not difficult to pinpoint which one of them is the one that likes to flaunt their wealth. But like outside of closed doors, there's a whole bunch of royal not royal no noble customs and mannerisms and all that stuff to maintain, and then that's where they've got all these responsibilities, I guess. They've got all these behaviors and appearances to maintain. Is there a hardness, opacity? Size, scale, filters, smooth the edges. What's this? Ooh, no. What is this? What? No. What? No. Okay, what if I just adjust your piece? It's not nice. Have a bit of the quilt spilling up. Okay, let's see. Are there ice? I don't need a chandelier for this. Sacrifice bowls, spices, meat, I guess. Where are all the fish towels? Where's all the food towels? Where are the tavern items? Is this all? Dum, 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 dum. Yeah, let's get a pig. These are cooked sausages. Ooh, yes, ribs. Chicken, spill bottles. Okay, so I guess I'm actually very limited on what goes into the cold room. Wait, no, but I'm getting distracted. I still need to put in rooms on the upper floor. Ow, ow, cramp. Andy's room, guest room. I guess then this means this could be the library study. And then we could have a small garden here. Like indoor garden greenhouse kind of thing. So I could put in windows on this side. And then, Why aren't there windows? Oh, it's looking in tavern. Holy shit. Gothic horror, lancet windows. What are these? Oh no, that's too creepy. I just need normal windows. It should be this side, right? Yeah. That's where the shutters are on the other side. Is my alignment off? I think it was off. Why does it look out of shape? It's smaller than usual. Okay. Wait, then we need a fireplace for this room also. Oh, that's unfortunate. The fireplace is right above the cold room. Ah, no, it's fine. It's fine. This is a magical setting. What am I looking for? Oh, I'm looking for the little thing here. Wait, what? Where did it go? Oh, here. I think this should be a T junction. Made a lot of changes, remember to save. Oh no. Oh, you're heading off. Okay. You take care, Wolfie. I'm gonna end soon also. Like once I've settled the layout. I mean, the layout's mostly settled, I guess. But once I've fully settled all this, then I'll end off as well. Maybe I want these two entrances to be much more easily accessible. So maybe I'm gonna do this a little weirdly. Just like how my actual house is built. It doesn't fit. Doesn't fit. I guess I'll scale down the door and hope no one notices. Everyone notices it. It's just uncomfortably narrower. I think the issue is actually that the entrance to it is too far up. So it's like, what if I take all these and just shift them down? there. Almost there. Okay, actually, we don't need this because I just realized. Oh, we're gonna fill in the space. This goes up. Let's get rid of this first. And I need the T joint. That's right, it goes in the square hole. Okay, we can't move down a layer, it needs to be above. Not that. What's this? Nah. I don't think this fits. I think this is too large. No, oh no. No. gonna need this to be here, and I'll move these guys over here. Okay, and then that's the layout of the house. Most of it. So, master bedroom here. And the closest room. Either that or I could flip it around, but then we don't want... No, we don't really want guests to be living next to the master bedroom. But funny enough, this room is visually larger than this. Okay. It is almost one. Hello, Meowduin. I have bad news. It is past noon. It is almost one and I am hungry. So I'm gonna stop it here. I'll continue the rest on my own time. Like, I think the main thing that prevented me from building this, like, weeks ago was just the lack of motivation, and starting stream was like... What am I using? I'm using Incarnate. So, I do have an Incarnate subscription, which gives me access to more assets and also the upscaling feature, but... you can use Incarnate for free. And Incarnate comes with a number of these stamps. So yeah, like all the map assets are stamped and I just place it in. I'm quite sure that there are additional features so that I don't have like 325 map objects filling up my space. You've used the free version. Nice. I think I'm actually not sure anymore what's the difference between the free version and the paid version, besides the customer service. Oh, and I guess the access to other people's maps, maybe. But yeah. I'll stop here. The rest of it I'll continue my own time. And of course there's gonna be some spoiler parts that I can't stream, so yeah, this is the general layout of the house. And eventually, when we get around to streaming the part 2 of Endercore's backstory, we'll get to see the full house. So there's that to look forward to. Let's head back to the loading screen and who to raid? Is there anyone to raid? Does anyone have suggestions? Or should I not raid? Raid. I don't really feel like raiding anyone in my follow list today. So, if you guys have suggestions, I could raid them. Otherwise, I'll probably just end it here. Oh, I forgot. I should shout out everyone. Maybe someone else playing D&D. Let's see. Oops, keyboard. Probably not. Nah, I. There's someone doing mini painting. I think I probably won't raid. Yeah, I probably won't rate in that case. I'll just end it here. Thanks for hanging out. Oh, right, I should shout out everyone. I always forget to shout out people. Okay, so let's see. There's Shiny, there's Wolf, there's Hermit that also streams. There's Geo, and then there's you. Shout out. Shiny Pudding. He does art streams. His art is very good. It's very beautiful. You should check out his art. I've forgotten who. Hermit occasionally streams. So but I think he usually streams Genshin. There's Geo Fox, who streams a variety of stuff. He's a furry streamer, and if you do go to his chat, remember to tell him that Geo is cute, okay? Everyone, Geo is cute. And then Meowduin. Meowduin also streams D&D. Wait, did I? Oh, I misspelled it! Yes. Okay. And yeah, I will end it here. I need lunch. And I am expecting an Amazon delivery, so my afternoon's gonna be full. And then in the evening, I'll be streaming again. I'll be streaming art. I'll be making a two-sided fridge magnet of my friend's cat. Okay. Have a nice day, everyone.